that you would be mindful of us. What do you see that's worth looking our way? We are free.
Welcome to the Word of God Online Daily Bible Study for May 14th, 2009 from the Living Bible, brought to you by www.wordofgodonline.com. Do not be afraid, for God is with you. Scripture verse of the day is Acts 5, 17 and 18. The high priest and his relatives and friends among the Sadducees reacted with violent jealousy and arrested the apostles and put them in the public jail. Scripture reading of the day is Acts 5, 12 through 42. As soon as Ananias heard of these words, he fell to the floor dead. Everyone was terrified, and the younger men covered him with a sheet and took him out and buried him. About 3 hours later, his wife came in, not knowing what had happened. Peter asked her, "Did you people sell your land for such and such a price?" "Yes," she replied, "we did." And Peter said, "How could you and your husband even think of doing a thing like this? Conspiring together to test the spirit of God's ability to know what is going on. Just outside that door are the young men who buried your husband, and they will carry you out too." Instantly she fell to the floor dead, and the young men came in, and seeing that she was dead, carried her out and buried her beside her husband. Terror gripped the entire church and all others who heard what had happened. Meanwhile, the apostles were meeting regularly at the temple in the area known as Solomon's Hall, and they did many remarkable miracles among the people. The other believers didn't dare join them, though, but all had the highest regard for them. And more believers were added to the Lord, crowds both of men and women. Sick people were brought out into the streets on bed in the masses, so that at least Peter's shadow would fall across some of them as he went by. The crowds came in from the Jerusalem suburbs, bringing their sick folk and those possessed by demons, and every one of them was healed. The high priest and his relatives and friends among the Sadducees reacted with violent jealousy and arrested the apostles and put them in the public jail. But an angel of the Lord came at night, opened the gates of the jail, and brought them out. Then he told them, "Go over to the temple and preach about this life." They arrived at the temple about daybreak and immediately began preaching. Later that morning, the high priest and his retinue arrived at the temple, and convening the Jewish council and the entire Senate, they sent for the apostles to be brought for trial. But when the police arrived at the jail, the men weren't there. When the police captain and the chief priest heard this, they were frantic, wondering what would happen next and where all this would end. Then someone arrived with the news that the men they had jailed were out in the temple preaching to the people. The police captain went with his officers and arrested them, without violence, for they were afraid that people would kill them if they used force on the disciples, and brought them in before the council. "Didn't we tell you never again to preach about this Jesus?" the high priest demanded. "And instead, you have filled all of Jerusalem with your teachings and intend to bring the blame for this man's death on us." But Peter and the apostles replied, "We must obey God rather than men. The God of our ancestors brought Jesus back to life again after you killed him by hanging him on a cross. Then, with mighty power, God exalted him to be the Prince and Savior, so that the people of Israel would have an opportunity for repentance and for their sins to be forgiven. We are witnesses of these things, and so is the Holy Spirit, who is given by God to all who obey him." At best, the council was furious and decided to kill them. But one of the members, a Pharisee named Gamaliel, somebody who was with the, misspelled that there, religious law and very popular with the people, he stood up and requested that the apostles be sent outside the council chambers while he talked. Then he addressed his colleagues as follows, "Men of Israel, take care what you are planning to do with these men. Some time ago there was that fellow, Theudas, who pretended to be someone great. About four others joined him, but he was killed, and his followers were harmlessly dispersed. After him, at the time of the taxation, there was Judas of Galilee. He drew away some people as disciples, but he also died and his followers scattered. And so my advice is, leave these men alone. If what they teach is merely of their own, it will soon be overthrown. But if it is of God, he will not be able to stop them, and you will find yourselves fighting even against God. The council accepted his advice, called in the apostles, had them beaten, and then told them never again to speak in the name of Jesus, and finally let them go. They left the council chamber, rejoicing that God had come to them to be able to suffer and dishonor for his name. And every day in the temple and in the city, they continue to teach and preach that Jesus is the Messiah. Well, my response to this is, in the above scripture, we see the apostles once again reaching the good news to the people of Jerusalem. These amazing men of God went about healing many people. They went about preaching the good news and carrying the message that Jesus had brought to earth. We also see in the scriptures above massive persecution coming down upon the apostles. For preaching the good news, they were thrown into jail. But we see a miraculous release of them from jail at the same time from an angel of the Lord. We can surely see God's hand upon the apostles in their time of great persecution. These men were about to be killed by the Pharisees, but a wise man stepped up and realized that God's judgment would come against the Pharisees if they killed these men. So the apostles were released. So how does this story in the scripture apply to us today? Well, today all over the world there is great persecution against Christians. You can check out a few videos I'm going to post up on the below this post. Here in the U.S. there is also persecution, but nothing like other regions of the world suffer at this time for standing out and up for the name of Jesus. But nonetheless, persecution is here and it is growing. Godlessness is growing at a rapid rate all around us. As the end times approach and the return of Jesus, which has been promised to us, nears, we know because it has been foretold in the scriptures that increased persecution is going to come, so get ready for it. We cannot look at this as doom and gloom, but as a time to stand. In the book of Ephesians from the Living Bible, chapter 6, verse 13, it says, "So use every piece of God's armor to resist the enemy whenever he attacks, and when it is all over, you will still be standing up." Let's read that again. So use every piece of God's armor to resist the enemy whenever he attacks, and when it is all over, you will still be standing up. This is a promise from God that if we are willing to put on the full armor that God has given us and told us what it is in Ephesians 6, then we can walk forward in the midst of persecution and know that everything is going to be okay. So when your enemy or persecution comes your way, remember to put on the full armor of God. Remember where we are heading. Remember what our future looks like beyond our time here. And rejoice in the persecution, as did the apostles when they were beaten and released, all under the name of Jesus. Thanks for listening to the Word of God Online. For more readings, you can go to www.wordofgodonline.com. And stand. Don't be afraid. God is with you, and in the midst of persecution, he is right there with you. Stand with the full armor and put on the full protection that is inside of Ephesians 6.